So this is how you create a contact widget. Long press the background, tap on widgets at the bottom. Look for bubble cloud group. I have the app installed twice, so I go with the first one. The top items are the home screen widgets. The yellow bottom ones are bubble cloud folders. We will talk about them in the second half of this video. So we have three types, A, B, C: app bubbles, bookmark bubble cloud, and contact bubble cloud. So we want the contacts. Press on the contacts icon and drag it on your home screen and resize it. It's important for it to be resized because the widget has to get the size it can fill with bubbles. Then it tells you, click on this yellow icon to add bubbles to this widget. If you have deleted widgets in the past, you will be able to restore them this way. But we are just going to start with blank now. I always recommend to name clouds. So this is just going to be a test cloud, but name them so you will find them later and be able to manage them later. You can also control the background color. Right now, it's set to complete transparency, so I will not see any background. But by default, it comes 50% transparent, and you can set any color, which means it is going to have some background coloring behind the bubbles. Let's keep it transparent for now. We can now add the bubbles using this yellow plus sign in the next section. So I just click there, and here I can see all my contacts listed. If I want, I can go up here and select one of my contact groups, but the system is the same. You simply tap on the people you want to add to this cloud. When you're done, press the check mark on the top, and these bubbles are added now. Now, tapping on these bubbles will take you to this measuring window because I had petals enabled. Okay, I will set the corners for now. It simply means I have to drag the green to the green, red to the red, and then click on the center check mark. We stayed in edit mode, but we basically set the size. So now if I press the check mark, if I click on somebody, the petals will appear. If I click outside, the petals will disappear. By default, you will have a pencil icon in the widget, but I turned them off. If the pencil is turned off, you have to double click on an empty area in the widget to get this toolbar. You can look up the website about all these options. Basically, tapping the circle plus will take you to the widget window, back to this window that we originally used to set up. Here, you can add more contacts if you want, or remove contacts. The ones highlighted are in the widget currently. You can actually swipe sideways to get to this screen. You don't have to press that yellow plus sign. And notice the bubble action is set to petals right now. Instead of petals, you could directly open WhatsApp, so you could have a contact cloud which directly takes you to WhatsApp for those people who show up in that cloud. Or you can send an SMS message, or you can call, and all of these are the options. I think a nice option is to have these petals appear around the bubble, and then you can choose what you want to do with that bubble. Okay, so this is how it works. If you go into edit mode, you will be able to click on a contact, and it's going to bring up the bubble edit screen. Here you can change the bubble size, delete the bubble from here also. Notice you have to long press on this trash can to actually delete the bubble. It's not going to delete the contact, it's just going to remove the bubble from this cloud. And you can also change the picture. So you can click on here and pick from an icon pack or import an image using the bottom button to take any photo and crop a circular part of it for your icon. I'm gonna cancel for now. There are again other videos and other posts explaining this part as well. But for now, let's just change the size of this bubble and save it. And you see now each bubble shows its size in the upper part. So most of the bubbles are size 1 or weight 1. Only this one is bigger, 3. This is the scattered layout. You can also change the layout. Here, the bigger one will appear in the center and the smaller ones around it. Or you can have just a grid and actually turn that grid around any way you want. And then the number, the weight, only controls their order. So the highest weight is the first one in this corner. And we also have this galaxy type of layout. And you can also click on this swap arrows, pick one, pick another one, and the two are swapped. The bubble sizes are kept. Let me go back. Again, pressing the check mark takes us back to how it was, and then you can just click on any of these items and it's going to bring up the bubbles around it. You can create as many of these widgets as you want in the premium version. Now let's talk about the contact folder. You see the yellow icon, folder contact bubbles. If I drag that to the screen, it's going to let me name it. So I'm just going to call it test folder and create it. So if it's a folder, you tap on it. Again, you can assign it to any cloud. We will start with blank. We will call it test folder here as well. And add some contacts to this one as well. I'm going to add a different set of icons to this one. You see, this is a floating cloud. The first one is a widget which appears on your home screen. This one is a pop-up cloud. So if you click on it, it's going to pop up. Actually, if you double tap on the background, you will be able to move it around. Even click on the corner if you want to make it bigger or smaller. Let's keep it the smallest. And you can move it somewhere. And next time you open it, it's going to open there. Again, double tap on the background to remove the top. And here you have a floating cloud, kind of like a folder. But otherwise, it works the exact same way. So you can click on these icons and the petals will appear around them. You can double tap and press the pencil to edit these ones. So you can click on one, change the size, and it's going to work the exact same way as the widgets worked. But this is a pop-up cloud or a folder. I call it a folder because, and now let's take it one step further. I'm actually going to delete this shortcut, remove. Notice I removed the shortcut, but the test cloud that we created is still saved in the app. So if I go back to my widget, I can actually add this folder to the widget. Down in this area, add folder bubble, I can add contact folder bubble to my contact widget. I'm gonna click here. I like that icon, save. Okay, it's asking us to add bubbles to this folder. Now, instead of starting with blank, this time I'm going to reuse this one here, which we created last time, the test folder with those 8 contacts. So I'm just going to select those. And there you go. Here they appear. If I close it, see how this contact folder bubble appears in our contact widget. So you can either tap on a person and get those petals or tap on this folder bubble to have the pop-up folder appear on the screen. And I usually like to move it over that bubble. So when I tap on this bubble, we will have the pop-up appear above that bubble. And you can stack these folders inside each other. That's the idea. To keep track of things, I really recommend naming your clouds. You see how handy it was that I was able to restore that pop-up folder, even though I already deleted the link to it from the screen. These are the contact clouds, only available to premium users, but they work very similarly to the app bubble clouds, which you can play with in the free version, and also to the bookmark bubble clouds. So an app bubble cloud, same way, you can drag it here. Instead of contacts, you can add applications to it. I'm just gonna add a couple of them. And you can as well add folder bubbles to this one. And notice that you can have an app bubble cloud and still a contact folder inside. So let's just add another app bubble cloud folder to this one. I save it. And we are going to add some. This one I'm going to add just blue bubbles. Okay, so just blue apps. Here you go. So notice I have this folder bubble in the app cloud. Let me make it bigger than the others. So there you go. So I have this folder bubble. If I tap on it, I get the blue icons, the blue bubbles. So that's the app bubble cloud. And you can have multiple clouds on the same screen, or you can have as many clouds as you want. And with app bubble clouds, a big added advantage is the possibility to set an icon pack. I'm using the standard One UI launcher, which doesn't work with standard Android icon packs, only with the special Samsung icon packs. But if you're using bubble cloud widgets, you can still use standard Android icon packs here. Look, I'm going to go into my cloud settings, go down to the icon pack section, and I can pick an icon pack. I have many icon packs installed. One of my favorites is the Lox icon pack, and I'm just gonna click on apply icon pack. So this icon pack is now applied to this cloud. This is a big advantage of bubble cloud, that you can use the standard Android icon packs on your home screen. And notice I can pick a different icon pack for each widget. We started with contact bubbles and got into all these other possibilities in the bubble cloud widgets.